All right, boys, we're back at it again, this time with a little bit of a different video. Today, we're going to go over my personal buy list for the upcoming rotation, which is going to happen in September of 2020. Of course, there's no tournaments going on right now because of the lockdown. So, of course, no one's buying cards IRL, and the market is all over the place, especially the new cards from Rebel Clash. You got bosses orders with like 10 bucks. Which to me is absolutely insane. Don't pick those up. I'm going to suggest a bunch of cards for you to pick up, though. Starting here with Zacian V, which not even 6 weeks ago was $30 a pop. Now half that price at $15. In my opinion, Zacian V is going to be the best deck in format coming out of the break. So definitely going to want to pick these up before they go back up in price. Now, I'm not sure if ADP Zacian is going to be the best. I personally still think it's worth a pickup, though, at $10 a card. So you could make ADP Zacian for under $200, which for a tier one deck is excellent. Now, another card that you should take a look at here is Computer Search, which is one of those expanded staples that always fluctuates in price. Now you see here $34 for a heavily played. Wouldn't recommend picking up heavily played, but the thing that caught my eye here was this listing right here, which is this moderately played from Yeti Gaming. Yeti Gaming is one of the most reputable card sources in the entire world, in my opinion. So you pick up the $37 moderately played. At the very worst, it is moderately played and you can still play with it. At best, it is a near mint or a lightly played, or at least you could probably get away with saying it's a lightly played. And when you try to trade it with someone, you could probably get that full value, almost full value out of it, which to me is big stonks. Or if you just need a computer search, moderately played is not terrible for $37. I think that's worth a punt, especially for those of you who've never had a computer search and say it's way too expensive, especially when the expanded tournaments come up. What ends up happening is all of these cards will spike by like $20-$30, all the expanded staples. I wouldn't say like VS Seeker does, but computer search for sure is one of those ones that goes up by $20-$30. I've seen this card go up to $100 before a tournament. So while all these tournaments are canceled, you might want to pick up some of your expanded staples. So that's talking about like Versus Seeker, talking Battle Compressor, Trainer's Mail. Although those cards don't get super high, it's still a good enough savings where if you have the disposable income and you plan on making a run to Worlds for next year and you have to play in expanded tournaments, there you go. Gotta pick these up. Now we're gonna go over another card here. These next two cards are going to be future investments. These are the two that I picked out, and these ones are from Rebel Clash. First one here is Twin Energy. Now, Twin Energy can be used on non-Vs and non-GXs to provide double colorless energy. And you're going to ask Derek, okay, well, that's not quite as good as double colorless energy, which, by the way, DCE was one of those broken cards in the entire world. At least a lot of people felt that way. I thought it was all right. I thought it was good, but people are saying it was so unhealthy for the format, et cetera, whatever. I'm not gonna get into those people. But Twin Energy here for 50 cents a pop, $2 for a playset. You're not gonna regret picking up this playset because even in expanded, you can use them on the EXs because Pokemon are really dumb. And they always forget to include EXs in their VGX, whatever, and any other restrictions. Bridget had this problem where she went from 50 cents to $8 a card. Now, I don't see that happening with this card, but I could very easily see people come back, play an expanded and use this with Toad or Weezing Spread, and then have this, or just something comes out later that can abuse this card in standard, and all of a sudden this price goes to like $2, $3, and you're gonna regret not picking these up while you have the chance. Same with Capacious Bucket. I can't say that word. I don't know what that is. So I'll almost call it Wet Bucket. Same with Wet Bucket here. Now in Expanded, it's gonna have a little less of a ceiling because you got Professor's Letter, which searches two basic energy cards anyway. So it doesn't really matter. But the fact that you could, it's 25 cents, man. 25 cent investment. The card's never gonna get lower than this. And if for some reason Frostmoth ever gets good, this card will spike in price in the same way that Fiery Flint did. Again, I don't think it'll go as high as Fiery Flint. Fiery Flint got up to like, I think it got up to like $6-$7 at one point. I could see this getting to $4 or $5, though, if Frostmoth ever got good, which at best case scenario, this thing does go up and all your Frostmoth boys are gonna need this card and you're gonna sell it to them for super high. Worst case scenario, you give these away to your Frostmoth boys and you tell them good luck because Frostmoth is big trash. Now, we're gonna go in here with probably my most expensive recommendation, but if you're trying to play Pokemon Stonks, this might just be the way to do it if you have a lot of disposable income. We're gonna take a look at the Battle Arena deck, Ultra Necrozma GX, right now retailing on TCGplayer.com for $60. And if you take a look at Jirachi's price, $20 per. And the thing is, with the Battle Arena deck, you end up getting two Jirachis. That's $40 of value right there. And they do use this this Jirachi, by the way. So you're getting $40 right there. And then, of course, you go on to, I think it's called Poke Awesome Code Catcher or something like that. It's an Android app. I will link it in the description below. But as you can see here, this is their buy list for codes, and this list is accurate. All these prices in this list, by the way, are accurate as of 10:20 a.m. on May 1st, 2020. So here we go. As you can see, the Battle Deck Ultra Necrozma is $20. So we do the quick maths. We got $20 for the code that comes with the box. You got two Jirachis, which is $20. Right there, you've made your money back. And if Jirachi for some reason goes up to $25, $30, $40 once everyone comes back from the quarantine, which very easily could happen. Jirachi at one point was $40, so I can see it going up again. You've just made money, which is a very good thing indeed. And lastly, I'm going to talk about two cards that people are going to try to use with Jirachi when we come back in September, because one of the things that happened with rotation is that we're losing Escape Board. So there are going to be two ways that I anticipate people try to use Jirachi. The first way is going to be Scoop Up Net, which, by the way, this card is already seeing a little bit of an increase of price. I checked this card yesterday and it was 40 cents. So now it's at 58 cents. This card's going up even a little bit higher. So I don't think it'll get higher than this, though, at least for a while. And the thing is with this card, it's another one of those really stupid things from Pokemon that it cannot be used with Pokemon V or GXs, but you can use it with EXs. And you got Wailord EX in Expanded, who is like 250 HP with buff padding. It gets to 300. So Wailstall, if Wailstall becomes really broken in Expanded, this card might get banned. But of course, you're not gonna see this card get banned anytime soon, because they're not going to, there's no results to go off of, and TPCI do not ban cards unless they show in tournaments that they really break the format. The other thing you can do with Scoop Up Net is you can scoop up your Shamans to reuse them, which to me is incredibly broken. But again, I don't think they're not going to ban this card and expand until we see actual tournament results. So pick these up while you can. And if they don't ban it, this card is going to go up in value for sure. Lastly, and now this is a card I'm not going to say you buy, but this is a card to keep your eye on. A Galarian Rapidash from Sword and Shield, 23 cents. The thing is, its ability makes it so that Jirachi doesn't go to sleep. So you can use Jirachi's ability without putting it to sleep, meaning you can retreat with a manual attachment. So I think people are going to try to run this either as a 1-1 or maybe even a 2-2. So this card might jump from 25 cents to maybe $1, and people are going to look for it and you're going to have them. I'm saying don't buy it, but if you got them in your bulk somewhere, you got a big stack of cards lying around somewhere. I had a stack of cards somewhere, but I think I moved them out of the way because I had to clean my desk. But if you have a big stack of cards and you see a Galarian Rapidash in there, don't throw it in your bulk. Pull it out of your bulk, hold on to it. Maybe it might increase in value, or maybe someone will be looking for it and you've got it for them. But anyway, boys, I really hope you enjoyed my buy list for the upcoming 2020 rotation, which is, by the way, Team Up On. So if you're not looking to play Expanded, You need to sell everything before before team up. Team up will be legal though, so keep your team up stuff. But anyway, boys, if you enjoyed this video and you like this content or any of my other content, maybe give it a look-see. And if you really like it, why not consider hitting that subscribe button, clicking that bell for the mobile notifications, and of course, follow me on Twitch. The channel name is above my head here, as well as, of course, the link to my channel is in the description down below, so you can watch me play PTCGO and other games live. But until next time, boys, this has been Derek for Table 500, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.